Now, before we dive into the course content, I'd like to give you a teaser or a taste of what you'll be able to do by the end of the course. Now, usually in my teaser lectures, I'd give one example to show students what they'll be able to do once done with the course. But in this course, you're going to learn so many cool things, and we're going to build more than 20 hacking tools. So it's unfair and it's really hard for me to pick only one example. Therefore, instead, I'm going to show you three examples taken from the three main sections of the course. Now, keep in mind, each one of these sections is divided into a number of subsections. So these examples are only a small fraction of what you'll be able to do once done with the course, but I think they'll work really well to give you a taste of what you'll be able to achieve once done. Now, since this is just a teaser, don't worry about how these programs work. We will cover how to write these programs in details. So for now, just sit back, watch the lecture and enjoy it. And then once you start the course, you will learn how to write all of these programs and much, much more. In the first example, I'm going to use two programs. The first one will allow us to intercept data sent or received by any computer on the same network. The second one will read this data and filter it to show us usernames, passwords, visited URLs, and so on. We're going to write these programs ourselves from scratch later on in the course. Now, these programs are running on my hacker machine, so let's go to the target machine and try to generate some traffic and maybe log in to a service. I'm going to go to hotmail.com and let's try to sign in. So I'm going to click on sign in and I'm just going to put some sample information. So I'm going to put a username and the sample password, and I'm going to hit enter. And now if we go back to the hacker machine, you can see that first of all, I can see all the requests. I can see all the websites they're visiting. And I can also see the username and the password that they logged in with. So I can see the username was zaid22@hotmail.com, and I can see the password was 123456. The second example that I'm going to show you is a backdoor. A backdoor is a program that when executed on a system, it allows us to remotely control that system. So basically hack it and gain full control over it. Now, just like all the other tools, we're going to program this from scratch, and I'm going to show you how to write this in a generic way so that you can use the information you learn here in many scenarios. For example, you'll be able to write a web server, a chat program, and so on. Now, right here, I'm already at the hacker machine, and as you can see, it's already listening and waiting for incoming connections. Once the backdoor gets executed on a computer, we will get a connection, as you can see here. Once we have the connection, we'll be able to use all the features implemented in this backdoor, which we're going to implement ourselves. So first of all, I have file system access. So if I do CD, it'll show me my current working directory. And as you can see, I'm in users Zaid downloads. That's basically because the backdoor is actually stored in this location. So I can do CD dot dot to go back one directory. And if I do CD now to see where am I, you can see I'm in Zaid. And we can also execute all system commands. And keep in mind, this backdoor works on all operating systems. It works on Linux, Windows, and OS X. So you can use the system commands of your target and they will work by default. So right now my target is Windows. So if I wanted to list the directories, I can do dir. And as you can see, I get a list of all the files and directories in the current working directory. Now I can go back in downloads by doing CD downloads. And if I list again in here, you'll see the files that we have in the downloads, which are the backdoor and the GTR image, which I have right here. Now, I also want to highlight a feature that we're going to program, which is the ability to download files. So I'm just going to do download, and I'm going to follow it by the file name that I want to download, and it's the image. So it's gtr.jpg. And as you can see, I'll see it automatically being downloaded in here. And if we double click this, we have the image intact and we're able to open it. Now I'm downloading the image just as an example, but it just goes to show you that you'll be able to download any file from the target system. You can also upload files, which is really, really useful because you'll be able to upload evil files, viruses, keyloggers, and so on. And as an example, I'm just going to rename this image to gtr2.jpg and I'm going to upload it. So I'm going to do upload gtr2.jpg. Now it's telling me the upload is successful. And if we go here again, you can see we have the new image. Now, if this was an evil file, because you're able to execute system commands from the backdoor, you'll be able to just call it from here and execute it remotely on the target computer. The last example that I want to show you is a vulnerability scanner. This is a program that can automatically discover weaknesses in websites and web applications. So all you have to do is just give this program a website. And first of all, it's going to discover all the links and all the pages in the target website. Then for each one of these pages, it's going to extract all the parameters and all the forms. And finally, for each one of these parameters and forms, it's going to submit code to discover vulnerabilities. Then once it's done, it's going to show me the results. And as you can see, it was able to discover an XSS vulnerability in here. Just like all the other programs, we're going to write this from scratch ourselves. So again, don't worry about how this works. And don't worry if you don't understand what a vulnerability is and all of that. We will cover all of this later on in the course.